revered member of our board of governors, Mr. Parth Sarathy, his son, Dr. Mr. Srinivas, dear colleagues and my students, history of MOP Vaishnav College, because part of the dreams of our revered member, Mr. Parth Sarathy, is going to come true. Mr. Parth Sarathy has always been wanting the students of MOP to be doing lot of things online. In fact, he has been dreaming that all the, like any other university like Massachusetts, MIT and many other universities in the West, our students should be able to have an access to learning resources at any point of time, and every student should know how to be a consultant and use the technology to the great advantage, and also be an entrepreneur, not only in learning but also being an entrepreneur.
Thank you very much, ma'am. I'm very happy to be here. I've been in touch with, I've seen all your magazines and the type of work you do. From my father-in-law, I've been getting to know about the type of work that's being done in this class. I have great admiration for all of you, and it's a great pleasure for me to be here and to talk to all of you. This stage a bit, it distances us. So I just want to tell you that whatever I'm going to talk about today, I would like you to interact with me, ask me questions, stop me at any point. You don't have to wait till I complete. You can stop me, ask me questions at any point, so that it becomes more of an interaction than a one-way delivery. Okay? What I'm going to talk about today is blogging. And in blogging, the most important point is this interaction, that anybody can post a comment and tell the blogger, your post is hopeless or your post is excellent, great. And that's the importance of Web 2.0. We are in the second phase of online ventures. So we are in Web 2, not Web 1 or Web 0. So this is very important that we interact with each other. And like Madam rightly pointed out, in 1 hour you can't do much, but this is only a very, very preliminary introduction to all these things. And I'm going to leave you my contact details for any of you to start this and then ask me questions, and we will be able to interact more that way. And in case we are able to meet again, we will continue with the interaction. So what we are going to talk about today is blogging, marketing and monetization. You can do blogging for as part of your own subjects, for your academic excellence, to show off your knowledge and skills, to create an image for yourself in the online world, to the whole world, not to only the people around here. And you can also earn money through blogging. That's what we are going to talk about. How many of you have visited sites and blogs? How many of you have seen blogs? Okay, how many of you use the internet to search for information? Google, MSN, Yahoo, all of you, okay? And some of you have visited blogs. How many of you have your own blog? Okay, at least a few of you have your own blog. So this is not something new to you. That's very good. I'm happy about that. In blog, so for those who feel that you want to know a basic information about blogging, we have some reasons for blogging, why should we blog at all. But later I will just show you some blogs online. We have the program here so that we can use the internet. And just after the introduction and after your questions and so on, I'm going to show you some of the blogs, some of the different types of blogs, so that you can have an idea. Even those who are already blogging can go to the next step. Those who are already blogging, do you earn some money through blogs? Do you earn money through your own blogs? No, not yet, okay? So you can have blogs for your own academic excellence. You can show off your academic skills. You can put up all your projects online for the whole world to see. Plus, you can also make money. These are the two parts we want to talk about today. Okay, why should we blog at all? As students, why should you blog at all, okay? As students, you are given a number of tasks and assignments. Even if you are writing a simple exam essay, what are you doing? You are collecting information, presenting it in your own way for a to answer a particular question. Okay, in a blog, you are going to do the same thing. You are going to choose a topic, collect information, present it in a readable format, easy to read format for others to benefit from. And good content is the king of internet. So if you have good content, original content, unique content, you can make a lot of money and you have name and fame for your contribution. So if you present a paper in your class, your whole class might see it, appreciate it, your teacher might appreciate it. But if you are going to put it online, okay, you have a vast readership. And with the RSS facilities and the readers online, everybody is looking for good content, unique content, which is what students can present. All your project reports, your college magazines, I've seen your lovely magazines, these can be online. And I know that many of you go and collect advertisements and so on for the magazines. The whole project includes all that. That can be done very well through blogging. So that's one way of your blogging, the themes of blog, the styles of blogs for e-zines, okay, electronic newsletters, electronic digests, okay, e-zines you can have through the blog. And when you go out, when you have your CV, if you say that you have a blog, that adds value to your CV. Okay, anybody, anywhere. Nowadays, with all the foreign companies coming into India, all that they are looking for is people who have some computer knowledge, not programming knowledge, not Java or HTML. Blog is something you can do with no knowledge of computers. So it's not for IT students. It's for any student right from the school level to whatever, I mean, if your subject is history, you can blog. You don't have to have any programming knowledge, no HTML, no Java, nothing is required. I am a teacher of English, so I am able to work online now and earn much more than what I made as a senior lecturer in a university. This is possible not because I have any special computer skills, but I have knowledge of internet marketing now. Today, I mean, I did not have it 2 years ago. I took voluntary retirement from a job as a teacher. I was teaching in a college and I was just teaching a little bit of computers to my students to produce teacher training materials. My students were to become teachers. So I was helping them to produce teacher training materials. Today, I am earning much more than what I earned throughout my career as teacher, mainly because I have learned the skills of internet marketing. That you can learn, all of you, some of you are marketing students, some of you are communication media students, all of you have these skills as part of your course too, and even without that you will be able to earn much more than, I mean, this can be an additional income even after you take up your jobs. Okay. There are different types of blogs, and we are going to talk about personal blogs and professional blogs. You can have blogs based on your hobbies, interests. Somebody is interested in music, somebody is interested in cricket, for example. So you can have a blog just on that. Or you can have professional blogs. Some people have blogs just to talk about their family. So I have all the photographs of my family and the family functions and things like that. I send it across to all my family members. That can be a very, very simple blog. Or as a class, the whole class has some assignments. So in my classroom, for example, I divided my syllabus into different topics and each student had just one topic to work on, collect data from the internet, summarize it, put it up on the blog, and the whole blog had all their topics covered in this thing. So that will be a very good experience of blogging, as well as you have readership. You have people who are interested in reading that. So whenever you blog, all that you need to find out is who will be interested in reading whatever I'm going to put there. Okay, suppose you are producing a magazine or a newsletter, you think of this, who is going to be my reader, who are going to read whatever I produce, who are the readers. Okay, similarly in blogging, you will choose the topic carefully, keeping in mind not only your interest, but the readers who are going to visit your blog. So you can earn money through various means. Do any of you know about Google AdSense or affiliate programs or whatever? Have you heard about this? What is Google AdSense? Do any of you know that? Okay, if you have a newspaper, for example, okay, the newspaper editor gets, the publisher gets advertisements from different people. He places the advertisements on his newspaper, he gets paid for it. That's why you are able to get the newspaper at a lower cost than what it takes to produce the newspaper. Or you have a magazine, you go and collect advertisements. You have one page advertisement and you get paid for that. And that covers the cost of your magazine, okay? Similarly, in a blog, you have this space, your blog space on that. You have got some good content. Because of that, visitors come to your blog and read your content. So you can place advertisements on your blog. Google AdSense is pay-per-click. There are different types of ads. Pay-per-click, pay-per-lead, pay-per-sale, okay? Pay-per-click means somebody comes to your blog, somebody goes to Google search and then searches for some content. Your blog, your URL, your site comes up in the list. They come to your site, they read your content, they look at an ad placed by Google next to your content that is also related to that topic, whichever topic you have worked on. They click on the ad. Because they clicked on an ad on your blog, you get paid. Google gets paid from the advertisers. They share part of that money with you because that ad is placed on your blog. So you can start your blog, just apply for Google AdSense. It's all free. You can get, once it's approved, your blog has about, say, 5 pages of content, you can apply for Google AdSense. Once it is approved, the Google automatically places those ads on your blog. You don't have to go and search for good ads which is suitable to your content and all that. Google robots do that automatically. The robots read your content according to the keywords in your paragraphs, the ads are placed. So anybody who comes to your blog searching for that information, particular information, find this ad interesting, they just click on it. And every time they click on it, you get paid for that. And similarly, you have affiliate programs where you get paid commissions for selling others' products. So ClickBank as a marketplace, for example. There are many, many like ClickBank. I'm just giving one example. You can go and search for ebooks related to your content and place the link on your blog. Somebody clicks on it, goes and buys that book, and you get 50% commission. So you have not written that book, you have not produced that book, you have not taken the trouble to do any of these things. You just place one link on your blog, that's all that you do. And somebody finds it interesting, they click and go and buy, and you get 50%, sometimes 75% commission for that ebook. Okay, and you can get resell products. You can buy the products and resell them. Or you can get 100% commission that way. You have just bought it once, you can sell it as many times as you like. Or you can have your own products. You choose any one area on which you can contribute. You have a small ebook, even a 10-page ebook you can have, you can sell it from your blog or site. In India, examination related things sell very well. That's what is my experience, more than anything else, okay? All over, once you have a blog, it's for the world. The whole market, whole world is your market. But if you think of Indian audience, okay? I have a blog on UGC, Net SLET examination, CSIR examination. That's the one which is visited by most of the Indians. For all the other blogs, I have Americans and all the others, USA and UK and all the other countries visiting the blog. But the Indians are most interested in examination related items. So suppose you can prepare a set of materials for any one examination or just the syllabus. I have just got UGC Net SLET syllabus on my blog. And everybody comes to my blog for that, and they click on some ads or some books they buy, and I get paid for that. Okay, dollars2rupees.com, sign up for programs. That gives you, you can just have a look at the URL there, I'll just show you later. That has a step-by-step plan. I mean, what are the things you can sign up for? You can just click and sign up. It's like filling in an email form, okay? How many of you have emails, your own email IDs? Okay, many of you, almost all. So if you know how to fill up an email ID, you can create your own blog. You can create your own programs and you can start earning right from today. It's as easy as that. So if you just go to that site, you will get the step by step. I mean, that is step three. I have got the link for step three because that has the link for ClickBank. But otherwise, you can go through the steps and fill up all the forms and sign up for programs and start your thing easily. Next one, please. Okay. That's a brief introduction about why we should blog or what are the various reasons we might want to blog. Okay, as professionals, what are the things you can do with the blog? Your subject, so whatever you are studying now as part of your course, suppose you put it up on the blog, some useful books you have found from the library, okay, from this library, from the university library, from anywhere else, the syllabus of your topic, some books you have found useful, some of the materials you have used, if you have got all that somewhere, all the coming students are going to visit your blog. You are going to have visitors, readers, because others who are doing that subject will be interested in reading that. That may be one very, very simple thing you might want to do. Then, about your projects, you suppose some teacher assigns you a project and you put it up, you put up a blog related to that project, and within, suppose you are doing a team project, even to share information between the teams or within the teams, intra-team or inter-team, you can put up all the details on the blog and up-to-the-minute information can be given. And any teacher will find it easy to evaluate also. They can get all that at a particular place, all the process you have gone through. Okay, I believe that many of the teachers here value the process more than the product. It's not just one submission, but the process you go through, the learning during the process. And you can, for example, give your ideas, advice, some shortcuts, some tips for other students, or if you are fond of music or whatever, your hobbies or interest, you can tell others how to go about it, what to do, your tips, you can share these things. Or say somebody is interested in cooking, you can have your recipes, okay, different things you can have. I mean, it's just a platform and you can use it for any purpose you want. Okay, suppose you have, you can have better communication amongst yourself as students. So each group of students does a blog and they visit each other's blogs, go and comment on the blog. See, in the class when we teach English, we advise that students edit each other's work and so on. You share the composition and edit the next person's work. You learn more and they learn more and so on. In a blog, for example, your team goes and visits the other person's team's blog and posts a comment. Okay, you have done this very well, but you could have added this and so on. This way you earn from each other. And you have if you have campus interviews, you can share this with the potential employers. Okay, these are the things that our students are doing. Okay, and they can get a better idea of you from the work type of work you have done through your blog. So you can have an exhibition. For example, in the institute where I worked, every year we used to have an exhibition where all the students' PowerPoint presentations and things, whatever they had done online, will be displayed for the people around, the schools, principals, and potential employers. We'll call, invite them and we'll show off our students' work. And like your exhibition you have in the college. And for the students to keep up with current events, most often the textbooks have old materials, okay? And we as teachers keep looking out for new challenging materials. Just before coming here, she asked me that I am looking for challenging materials. One way is to just tell the students, find challenging material and assign it to the other group. Put it up on your blog, go and ask the other students to visit your blog and find out the challenging assignment, solve it, and so on. I mean, it's not only the teacher finding everything. The students can find it for the teacher also, as well as the other students. So the blog has that kind of facility for you. And you can present project reports and other things in a better manner, in a more impressive manner. And because of all its sound effect and visual sound effect and all that, it's a better presentation than somebody reading out a report. And your resume is, of course, going to be much, much better if you even just list one blog in your name at the end of your this thing. All the employers nowadays are looking for an email, whether you have an email or not, and whether you have a website or a blog. Okay, so it's necessary. Okay, we are going to the next slide, but if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. I mean, you don't have to wait till I complete. Any questions? Okay, if you feel uncomfortable, I can come down with a hand mic and stand there if you feel that there is a distance because of the stage and so on. Shall we go on to the next slide? Okay, we'll finish and then take up the questions maybe. Okay, I told you about this monetization of blogs. One is Google AdSense. We can have more questions later if you have doubts. Google also has a referral program now. In the referral program, somebody clicks on something, goes and fills up a form or downloads a free report, and you get paid for that. They pay more for referral program than for AdSense. ClickBank ebooks, CDs or DVDs for sale. You can even say convert your magazine, whatever you produce, in the form of a CD or DVD and place the information on your blog that we want to sell this. So anybody who is interested in it would buy it. And you can have your own ebooks on any topic. I mean, even your school projects, college assignments, projects, you can have ebooks based on that. Okay, an ebook, all of you know what's an ebook, right? You don't have to print and store them in your rooms and they take up your space and piles of things. Here, it is online. And if anybody places an order, you just send them one link and they get the ebook. Okay, I have an ebook for example, UGC Net Slet Paper 1. So I don't have to print it, I don't have to store it, I don't have to keep it with me. Whenever somebody says, I want this and they pay me, I just send them a download link and they download it. So my cost as a publisher is very, very minimal. And my time and effort, that is all is the cost. Okay, I sit down, write and put it up there. And then anybody who wants it, they can get it immediately. I don't have to post it. They don't have to wait for 1 week or 10 days to get it. So it is beneficial for both the sides. So you can have ebooks on, say for example, you are doing BCom or BBA or whatever, even you can have an ebook related to that subject, and it's possible. Thank you. Amazon is one, this thing, you have a marketplace for books there. So you can just place those links. You have not produced a book, but there are books available. You can keep those links on your site, and if somebody clicks and goes there and buys the product, you get paid for that. So one is your own products, but you need not start with your own product, but because that will take time for you to do. So you start with others' product. You can just start with Google AdSense right away and then start with others' products and then go on to having your own products. Yeah. So how do you have, there are different types of blogging platforms, okay? The one is blogger.com. This is Google's blogging platform, that is blogger.com. And you have WordPress. There are two types in WordPress, wordpress.com and wordpress.org. If you go to wordpress.com, you cannot place Google AdSense there. So if you are interested in monetization, it's better not to go for .com. Go for .org, org, okay? And there is movable type, which is a little more advanced than these two. WordPress is better than Blogger in the sense of having more plugins and so on. We will see the features now. Next one, please. Okay. Blogger is absolutely free. Okay, you can right now, you can spend 5 minutes, sign up for an account, start a Blogger blog, and place Google AdSense once you have 5 pages. At least 5 posts you should make, and then only Google will, you apply to Google for AdSense, and they look at your blog and then approve. Okay, it will take about 1 or 2 days to approve. Then you can place your ads on as many blogs as you want, as many sites as you want. You have to get the approval only once. And then you can have 100 blogs or 100 sites. Google doesn't mind, okay? So that is completely free. WordPress.com is free, okay, but you cannot have Google AdSense. WordPress.org, that's the third one, that is also free, but you need your own domain name and web space. You need to buy your URL, your site link, you need to buy that domain name, and you need space for your blog. Where do you want to keep your blog? This you need to buy. For this you need to spend about $50 per year, say about 2000 rupees or whatever it comes to. Okay, under $50 per year, if you spend, you can have a WordPress blog. Or if the college or the university has a blog, has a site, they have already bought a domain name, they've already bought web space, you can have a number of blogs within that. Okay, so you can even group together and buy one web space. One web space means you can have number of blogs under that. Okay, but if you want to have it individually, for me, I mean, I would like to have it individually because my whole earning depends on that. I don't want to share it with anyone. So I have spent this much, but I earn much more than what I spend than that. Movable type is completely paid. I don't think you should go in for this now. You should start with the absolutely free one, Blogger Blog, and try your hands at that, get an experience of how to do it online and things like that, and then go on for the other ones, okay? And whatever you earn through Blogger Blog, you can reinvest and go for the paid versions. Okay, to start with the Blogger Blog, later I will just show you online, but in the PPT you can see that it's blogger.com. You just go and create a free account. That is an email. It is similar to creating an email account. To create an email account, you fill in your username, password, and so on. It's just similar to that. If you have, any of you have Gmail, how many of you have Gmail? Okay, many of you have Gmail, so even the first step is not necessary for you. Those who have Gmail account, they can directly start their Blogger account with that. If you have any other email account, there's no problem. You have to just start, fill up a form with that email if you want, and go on to the next stage and choose a name for your blog and a template for your blog. Okay, different templates are available. You just click and choose. Okay, with a mouse click, your blog will be ready. When you choose a name, just be a little bit more careful. The name should reflect the topic of your blog. Okay, when we teach composition to you, in the essays to you, when we ask you to write essays, we tell you the title is very important. Okay, the title gives an introduction to others what your essay is about. Similarly, all these skills you can practice much more efficiently by going online. By just starting a blog, you will understand all this much more, I mean the importance of all this better. So you have to choose a good name that reflects your topic that others are also interested in. So choose a topic very carefully and think of what others are interested in reading and choose according to that. And you can also enhance your blogs with page elements. In this wanttolearn.com, if you go to wanttolearn.com, you will find some video tutorials there. So even for those who find it difficult to fill up the forms and so on, they can watch the video tutorial, learn how to do it, and set up your blog. It will not take you more than a few hours, even if you are very slow on the computer. I think many of you will be able to do it within 1 hour. And if you are able to make five posts means just 5 paragraphs or 10 paragraphs at the most you are going to write. And make very short posts. Don't write long essays in your blog. Have short posts. Suppose you have a long essay you want to put, divide it into sub-paragraphs, subheadings, okay? And for each subheading, have one post with a good title. The title is what Google catches when it searches for, when you search for some topic. Those who have better titles, their sites are listed in Google. Okay, that's how you are going to get this thing. So there is a video tutorial there which will tell you how to do this. But you will be able to do it if you just go to blogger.com. There you will find all the instructions how to do it. So it shouldn't be very difficult for you to start it. Now, for the WordPress and Blogger Blog, what is the difference? Why do we want WordPress blog at all? If Blogger is free and you can earn money through Blogger Blogs, why go in for WordPress at all? Okay, some of the reasons are there are more features, there's more flexibility in a WordPress blog. Once you start using the blog, once you start earning money through the blog, you will not be satisfied with blogger blogs. Because all the blogger blogs will have the link as, say, xyz.blogspot.com. Okay, blogspot.com is Google's link. So anybody who sees blogspot.com will know, okay, this is a blogger blog. So it is not based on your domain name or your web server. It's placed on Google's server, and the domain name is also Google's. You have the choice. Okay, I have, say, for example, iPod.blogspot.com. So I have a blog about iPods, and my domain name, my blog name is iPod, okay, or iPod Zone, and Google will add blogspot.com to that. That is how it will sound. The URL becomes a bit longer, and there are more flexibility, more things you can add in a WordPress blog. I will show you samples of a WordPress blog and a blogger blog also. You can install unlimited WordPress blog on a single domain. So if you have a site for the college, then you can have many, many WordPress blogs installed under that one domain. So you don't have to buy a domain name for each one, unless you want to. If you want to, fine. But if you don't want to, you can have it under one domain also. You can customize the look of your blog using a variety of templates available. There are thousands of templates available. In Blogger blog, you have choice, but very limited choice. In WordPress, what they have done is, any programmer can submit a template to them for free, and they offer it to us for free. So all this is free. So you have more choice for the templates, okay? And if I am a programmer, I want to show off my skills. So I prepare a template, I give it away to WordPress.org for free, and they have a collection of templates, and from where all of us can choose one for free. And all of us can choose a different template. None of our blogs will look similar. In a blogger blog, because there is limitation, you have limited choice. Plugins. Have you heard of plugins? There are many, many plugins. Are any of you members of this group, Orkut or StumbleUpon, things like that? You know, I mean, Yahoo groups, and there are many, many like that. Social bookmarking sites. Many of you are members of that. So, you, once you have a blog, you want visitors to come to the blog. So what do? You have these plugins which will give some symbols at the end of your post. Somebody who comes to your blog will click on it and bookmark your blog in their favorite social networking place, Orkut or whatever it is. Okay, there are many, many, Gather or Orkut, or hundreds and thousands of them are there. So they will bookmark it there. Anybody who comes to Orkut will also see this blog and come to your site. So once I have a blog, I want visitors to come. Not in one or two person, but in thousands, in millions. Okay? So these are ways to get people to come to your blog. So these plugins help you do that. WordPress has plugins. Blogger blog do not have these plugins. So we use WordPress. And you can install plugins to monetize your blog or optimize it for Web 2.0. Web 2.0 focuses on interaction, not one-way learning, but interaction. No one person should go on doing that. Here you have the choice. Somebody can post a comment and say, your blog is very good, or the information is good, but I want this information, more of this information, and so on. Okay. So there is Web 2.0 wealth system. I've given you the link. That's one of my blogs, wanttolearn.com/internet-marketing, internet-marketing. Okay. So here you will find video tutorials for installing a WordPress blog. WordPress blog is slightly more difficult than blogger blog because you have to buy a domain name. You have to put that domain name and install a WordPress blog. So you need video tutorials for that. Step-by-step video tutorials are available for this, okay? I would suggest you start with blogger blog, get used to it, then go on to WordPress blog, watch the tutorial, learn how to do it, and go on with it, okay? Now the features of the blogger blog, I'm going to show you one sample. Okay, this is one blogger blog. What I have got here is, see, on the top there, that is the Google AdSense in blue. The title, yeah, you have, but next to that, these are the AdSense. Can you see the blue link, hyperlinked ones? Under that you will see ads by Google. Okay, these are the Google AdSense ones. And I have, in between you have videos. Google has videos. You have heard of Google Video? So instead, I cannot post content every day on my blog, or the content I post may be limited. So all that I have to do is to get an RSS feed of the Google Video. Just put it there. Anybody who comes to my blog, if they are interested, they will watch the video. And I get more visitors, and more visitors stay on my blog for a longer period of time, my blog gets a better value in the search engines. And I have AdSense above and below the Google videos, okay? And on the right side, if you see ClickBank products, these are books by ClickBank. I just went to ClickBank Marketplace, collected some of the books that will be relevant to my this thing, and I placed the link there. Anybody who comes to my blog, if they click on that, go and buy it, I get a commission for that. For Google Ads, I don't have to search anything. This thing is on best books, okay, the title of the blog. Look at the ad, free ebooks by big names, downloadable books, earn extra income, free ebook downloads. So Google chooses these ads automatically. So I don't have to do anything. I have a bit of code which I have inserted, and every time the ads will differ, and I'll get new ads every time, and it will go on. I don't have to do anything. For the ClickBank, I have chosen these are the books I want to place on my blog. Okay, and I have a subscription form there. Anybody who comes to my blog, if they want more information, I collect their name and email. That's a very good idea, to collect the name and email, because I will put it through an autoresponder. I don't know if you have, maybe it's too much for you, but I can contact them through email, and if I have some product to sell, I can contact all these people and tell them, why don't you have a look at this new product? So for such purpose, or I have a new post there and I can tell them there is something new, come and read my blog and so on. Can you go to the next screenshot? Here I have taken a video from YouTube. Google has bought YouTube for $1 billion, now more than $6 billion or whatever. So, but you have YouTube videos. These are available for free, and I have just placed it there. I mean, I did not create this content, okay? And I did not produce this video. I can produce my video and keep it in YouTube, but I have not taken all the trouble to do all that, okay? This is just one of my blog out of so many blogs. I don't have the time to put content myself. I have collected important content relevant to my topic, and I have placed it there. There's a small paragraph there and a video there, and on the side you can see Google AdSense, okay? So anybody who watches the video, while they are watching, they are curious, and then they click on, say, the home of ebooks. And because they clicked on it, I get paid. Okay, so I place the video and the AdSense side by side. So if somebody is watching for some time, say 5 minutes or whatever, you keep on doing something with the mouse. So somebody would feel like clicking, and then they will do it. This is, they are optimization, they call, monetization, optimization. How do you place it? Where do you place the ads? What color you should have for the ads and all this. There's a lot of research that has been done on all this. That's a huge, vast topic. But this is one simple technique. This is common sense, for example. Okay. Next, we'll see one WordPress blog as a sample. Yeah. This is a WordPress blog. Here I told you we have video tutorial for how to install the WordPress and so on, Web2O system. This is the post I have made. Okay. And I have got these symbols. Okay, these are social bookmarking symbols. This is done through a plugin. So there is Delicious, there is so many other things. Okay, you just click on it and you go and bookmark my site on your favorite networking site. So people from that networking site come to me. There is Technorati, which is a supermarket of all the blogs there, a collection of library of all the blogs. So I have got the links to Technorati, so people from there will come to me. I have got RSS readers, so anybody who wants to read my blog continuously. Every post that I make, they will subscribe to that reader and they will get it through their reader. And I have email subscription, so they will subscribe through email. Want to get blog updates? Enter your email ID. So if their email ID is done, the feed burner, you see the red big symbol there, feed burner automatically sends them my information. See, I have to produce only the content. I don't have to worry about all this. I have produced the content. Number two, I have placed the options there. And you as a visitor, you find that interesting, you subscribe to my blog. Feed burner takes care of sending the information for free. I don't pay for that. So this is the advantage of any online work. Do you think, suppose you have a magazine, for example, okay, and somebody, I mean, you have to send the magazine by post to 100 people. Will anybody do it for free for you? You have to pay for that, and you have to have somebody sitting there and doing it. Because all this happens through robots automatically, okay, feed burner gets money in some other way, not by charging me. Google gets money, okay, not by charging me, but by charging somebody else. So all this happens. So I, as a blogger, like a newspaper editor, content producer, I don't have to worry about anything. I have to worry about my content. If I have good content, everything else is taken care of. The marketing part is taken care of. But I have to know about these marketing steps. Okay, if I have just a blog, none of these there. Okay, who will read my blog? Maybe my mother, maybe my father-in-law, because he reads everything. Nobody else will read it. Okay, but because I have those options there, that much internet marketing I need to know, that what are the things I need to have there to spread the word across, to disseminate information. I need to know that. Once I know that, I place it there once. I don't have to do it every day. I just place it there once and I put in a content. Then my blog works for me, earns for me 24/7, 365 days and year after year. Okay, it's not just one time earning. So I get repeat visitors or unique visitors, but year after year I can earn through that. Okay, so the ease of setting up a blog and the ability for us to produce good content is important. So these two things can work for us and we can monetize it. And monetization is not our main concern. Our main concern is to have good content, good things for to add to our CV and to prove that we have done our academic work well. Okay. Next. Okay, what are the plugins that are available? So you can have audio, video materials. You can record your own this thing. You can have materials in Tamil and other languages also. You can record and have audio materials in different languages. And you can have photo galleries. You can have social bookmarking symbols there. You saw them there. And you can have ClickBank, Amazon products. For all these, you have plugins for the WordPress blog. So that's the advantage of having WordPress blogs. Then these are the resources, and we'll just leave it there as that. The monetization of the blog, you can have the step-by-step steps in the first one, dollars2rupees.com. If you remember that site name, you can go there. How do you earn in dollars when you are in India? That is the site about. The site is about making money online in India. You earn in dollars when you are in India. And wanttolearn.com money zone has much more information about making money, not just in India, in anywhere in the world. And we get visitors from all over the world for that. And audio tips on internet marketing, we have on this blog, wanttolearn.com internet marketing. And video tutorials for blogger blog as well as WordPress blog, you have in these two sites. The last one is most important, askrangu.com. My name is Ranga Naiki. Many of the people in the north and west or wherever, they cannot pronounce it very easily. So Rangu is how they call me. Okay, and all of them send me questions through askrangu.com. And I always respond to this thing. There's a small form there. You have to write your name and email ID and write your question and click send. Then I will respond to your question based on whatever you need. You start your blogger blog And if you get stuck at some point, you don't understand something, you can send a question. If the question is useful for all the others who contact me, I put it up on my blog for everybody to read. If the question is specific to you, I answer you through email. So this 1 hour is very little time, so but we can keep in touch later also after we finish this thing. But you I suggest that you start something and send me questions. So I'm just going to go down now and show you on the internet one or two of these blogs. Okay, and by the time I would like you to think of some questions to ask me. Thank you. .blogspot.com. Okay, and what I write here is a URL, and the name I have chosen the name What to Pursue as the name of this blog. Blogspot.com is how Google gives it to me. Okay, it's not on my server, it is on Google server. And all the blogs will have a title and a brief description of the title. Okay. And you can see here the ad, because it's a teacher related blog, all the teachers who send me questions or other people who are related to academic questions, not internet marketing questions. I have another blog for answering internet marketing questions. This is mainly for academic questions. So you can see the Google ads, Teach Visa Australia, so on. And you can see here ads by Google. So this is the ad Google has given to me for my blog, depending on what is the topic of my post, what is my blog about, okay? And I have got these Google videos